great to have you guys. Firstly, Neve, we'll start with you. For those who might not have heard the term before, can you explain to everyone what catfish actually means?
Well, if you haven't heard the term catfish by now, I don't want to tell you because you're probably a perfect candidate to end up on the show Catfish. But essentially, what the word has become known now as is someone who creates a fake internet profile and then uses that profile to engage often in romantic ways with strangers on the internet.
And Catfish, the TV show, is what you both work on, and it's back. And this season is quite different. You guys are tracking down the truth in relationships to see if people are who they say they are, all while being in lockdown. Now, has that made it more difficult?
It has its challenges, for sure. I mean, we are working from home just like everyone else, so any technical difficulties that you might have trying to get on a Zoom or sending emails and stuff like that, we experience the same thing. But it's been exciting trying to just navigate the entire process and, you know, figure out how this was going to work in the first place. And I think that it's been great. I love the episodes. You know, we're still filming and it's still exciting.
I am a big fan of the show, and what really surprises me is that when you finally do track down the catfishers, they often have sad stories. They're not doing it because they're evil people, most of the time anyway. What are your thoughts on that, Neve?
Yeah, I would tend to agree. The sort of typical person who you would call a catfish is most likely someone who, for whatever reason, created a fake profile to either explore their sexuality or interact with the type of people that they are not comfortable interacting with in their real life or whatever. And without really assuming it would lead to much, ended up stumbling into this flirtation and then relationship with someone on the internet and not really knowing when and how to tell them the truth about who they are. So while we do have some revenge stories and we have some scam stories on this season, you know, oftentimes it is someone who just kind of carries the weight of this lie and doesn't know how to tell the truth.
We're in season 8 of the show. Is there a story that absolutely stands out to you from all the years you've been helping people?
Well, with my dog barking in the background. See, this is how it is.
Yeah.
Filming the virtual episodes. You never know what's going to happen. It's like, is it an Amazon delivery? It's unclear. Anyways, as far as episodes that stand out, there's so many. There he goes again. This is real life. This is what we're dealing with. Neve, you take it. Let me get my dog.
Yeah. I mean, I would say there are definitely some moments that have stood out that kind of are seared into my memory from the show. But it's hard to choose one because each episode is so vastly different than any other. Not only because you're bringing two very different people from often different places of the world together, or certainly the country, but also because everyone's background and history and motives are always so different. And that's honestly, you know, you could say it's often easy to predict that the person they're talking to isn't the person in the photos. But what you can't predict is the huge backstory that kind of explains how and why that person came to create that fake profile. And so, you know, it's hard to pick a one particular moment, because when I think back and go over all the different episodes, I have the same sort of thought each time. I'm like, oh my God, that's right. And I couldn't believe that, or I still can't believe that that happened. So it's hard. Tough to pick one.
Yeah. What do you say to people?
Even looking at the clip, the clips that are rolling right now, like even looking at that, I forgot about the fact that we had an episode where the girl didn't even show up.
What about that Hawaii episode?
That one was crazy. So there's
no, that you're right. You're right though. I forgot about the one with what's his name? That sweet guy,
Nathan.
Right.
The stakeout.
He had no idea that the girl he'd been in love with for like 8 years had been homeless and had a baby. And it was like a national news story that this baby was missing. It was like crazy.
Well, this is the thing. How do people fall in love so deeply online with someone they've never even met, never even spoken to? How does that even happen?
I mean, I think a connection is a connection. And, you know, whether it's online or in person, I think that people, you know, experience love in different ways. And I'm open to all different ways. But I think that now more than ever, living in this weird pandemic experience where we're all on lockdown and everyone is looking to find a connection, you know, having someone sometimes to talk to is better than having no one at all. And sometimes knowing the truth is worse than, you know, not knowing. So I think that that a lot of times is how these things come to be and happen. But, you know, I think at the end of the day, everyone just wants love. And I don't see anything wrong with that. But yeah, you definitely want to make sure you're not being taken advantage of in ways that are traumatizing.
Well, given the amount of lies uncovered on the show, is there any hope that real love can exist online?
I think so. I mean, I think we're in a time now where this is how people are meeting, okay?
Are you peeling corn?
So I am. I'm shucking corn because it's my job to make dinner tonight for the fam, for my kids. So if I don't start doing this now, I'm in big trouble, okay?
No catfish on the menu?
Well, this is just the vegetable. This is the vegetable.
Right, okay. I don't know what
the
makes protein good eating, is apparently. Tonight. Makes good eating.
I think what we've all learned is that dating now is a digital thing. At least it starts that way. I know a lot of people who are going on first dates through Zoom calls, not just because it's a better way to maintain a physical separation, which allows you to have a bit more of an emotional connection or intellectual one, but also just because it's safer. And these days, you know, everybody's health and safety is priority numero uno. So I think it's great. I think this weird phase that we're going through and this awkward stumbles that we're taking, obviously, as a global community, hopefully will all lead to smarter and more successful internet dating in general.
Nothing too corny.
Yeah.
That is hilarious. That has never happened in all of our time on the show. That's amazing. That is definitely a highlight. You can catch Catfish.
This may be a news first, I think.
I think so. You can catch Catfish on MTV every Tuesday at 9:30 p.m. on Foxtel and Fetch. Nev and Kamie, thank you so much for joining us. Can't wait to see the new season.
Thanks for having us.
Thank
Come
you.
Over for dinner thank sometime.
You better.